Hey, how's it going, everybody? Scott Spritzer here, DocSports.com. Our update for Wednesday, January 6, 2021. Free pick in college baskets coming up in a moment. Speaking of college baskets, we are on fire. This entire season in college basketball has been going our way. And we are undefeated in college and pro basketball this week, Monday and Tuesday. And in fact, we cashed another 7-star play on Tuesday. Kansas Jayhawks were in a fantastic bounce-back spot, and they took care of business on the road over TCU. Also, NBA, man, I saw, as you guys did too, that Kevin Durant was going to be out for a few games. We saw that line get over-adjusted where the Nets became a 4.5-point dog at home to Utah. We knew that Kyrie Irving and the rest of the Nets would look at this as a chance to pick up the slack and get this team back on track, and they did so, and then some more, with a 34-point win for us over the Utah Jazz. So sweep so far this week on Monday and Tuesday in baskets. So we're going to look to go from 4-0 to 7-0 because we got three basketball plays on Wednesday on my homepage at DocSports.com. Couple in the NBA, one in college baskets. Let's continue the red hot season run in college basketball. Let's go to 7-0 with college and pro hoops on Wednesday's slate. Also got soccer. That's where we're starting our day on Wednesday afternoon action in soccer, where we've been on a great run. This is another plus money side on Wednesday afternoon. We're up over $3,000 going back to November with soccer. And PGA, well, they tee off on Thursday in Hawaii at Kapalua, and we do have a first round play right out of the blocks, which is available on my homepage at DocSports.com on Wednesday. Back on August 1st of the PGA, I went full-time, 100% focused on round-by-round daily matchups, and since then we've gone 29-17 and up over $3,000 for $100 per unit players. Let's keep it going this week. So that's everything that's going on for me on a Wednesday. The three basketball plays, of course, the star of the show. Tomorrow, of course, we got football Thursday, and we'll talk a little bit more about what we've got going for the weekend in the NFL and, of course, the college football title game if it doesn't get postponed and moved back. We'll tell you a little bit more about that on Thursday's video. Before I do get to the free play, a real quick note. I did want to give you a betting update in the NFL thus far. The books that report to me, and these are the books that aren't afraid to take a bet. The team that's getting the most action, both from the public and the sharps, those New Orleans Saints, they're getting about 65% of the tickets. They're getting about 90% of the money thus far, laying 9.5 to 10 for the most part at home to Chicago. Only one Joe's versus Pros matchup thus far, and that is the Rams-Seahawks clash. Seahawks laying about 4 points, 3.5's out there too. They're getting 55% of the tickets, the public action, but the Rams are getting a little bit more than half of the sharp money, about 53% of the money on the Rams thus far. And of course, if you're going to play this game, keep an eye out on whether Jared Goff is going to be a quarterback for the Rams. He's listed as questionable as I cut this video. All right, let's get to the free play for Wednesday's card. And we're looking at a Big East battle between Georgetown and Butler. Butler off to a disappointing start, obviously. This team's not playing well at either end of the floor. They're allowing teams to make almost 50% of all shot attempts, whether they be two-pointers or three-pointers combined. And I think they're in a tough matchup here. They'd like to get Aaron Thompson back, but I just don't like the way this team's playing at either end of the floor right now. And as far as Georgetown is concerned, you know, they put four guys in double digits. Blair's averaging almost 20 points per game. I also like the fact that they got two players averaging over 8 rebounds per game. I think they can get some second and third chances if need be against this Bulldogs lineup. So we're looking at Georgetown here. And again, they're getting, as I'm looking at all the books that are in front of me on my screen, about 16 books, a lot of 4.5s out there, some 5s, an open 5 just about everywhere, but a lot of those books have come down to 4.5. And again, we're going to recommend a play on Georgetown plus the points. Also wanted to mention a real quick note about Butler. If you look at their defensive numbers, I mean, just go right down the list, they're just horrible. They're 323rd in effective field goal percentage allowed. Their turnover percentage on the defensive end is like 250th in the nation. 3-point percentage allowed, 291st. 2-point percentage shooting allowed, 318th. I mean, it just goes right down the line. And 2-point shooting for Butler, they're hitting just 45.6% of their twos, which ranks 265th in college basketball. Like Georgetown here, plus the points, that is our free play for Wednesday. And again, don't forget, star of the show for me, college basketball, the NBA, as we look to go to 7-0 this week on the hardwood. And don't forget, if you're not yet a member, you can click on that link down below the video and get yourself set up for a free $60 account, which you can then use on any of my daily packages or anybody else at DocSports.com. If you like the videos, click on the thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe. I'm Scott Spritzer, DocSports.com. We'll be right back here on Football Thursday with our next free update.